text by?
Patrick Shanley.
Patrick Shanley, that's right. Where's my money? Here it is.
How's Kenny?
I think Kenny hates me.
He does not.
We've been together for so long, and his life's so not happening. He's suffering so much joy.
How's the band?
The band broke up. His wedding ceremony is a big deal. But most of the time, he just sits around the apartment and looks at me like I'm the thing that he is like.
Is he depressed?
He's a lazy stone drummer in a cheap Hawaiian shirt. He's like a depressing piece of furniture. What's your husband doing?
He's a lawyer.
A lawyer? What happened to that other guy?
Who?
You know who.
Tommy. Yeah, I knew that wasn't gonna work out. That was just sex.
You were nuts about him.
He was a porter. I wasn't gonna marry a porter.
Did he ask you?
No.
That thing you guys have is hot.
He never saw us.
Saw the way you looked. All over the way you look.
Yeah, well, that was hot.
Feel like running something by you.
What?
Maybe not.
All right.
I'm having an affair.
Oh, wow.
Who? 6 months now.
Does Kenny know?
He acts like he doesn't know, but I mean, there's evidence.
Phone calls?
No, bruises.
He's violent?
We're violent. He was born of Latin.
He's Latin?
No.
Uh-huh, so he had two.
No, we're in it together. It sounds bad. It's hard to explain.
Why are you telling me this?
I haven't told anyone.
Then why me?
He slaps me. He spanks me. He makes me crawl around on the floor like a dog. He calls me names. And then I go home to Kenny and ask if nothing happened.
So Kenny knows.
Kenny knows so much weed he might even be something on TV.
He must know.
He's English. He knows what Kenny knows.
And this guy knows this?
He's read a book that God wrote on my flesh. It's like I've always been afraid to say what I wanted. He knows what I want, he makes me do it.
Get this,
he gave me a gun.
Hey, what?
Sometimes I'd be headed home late, he was worried about me. So he gave me a little gun. How sexy is that?
Not necessarily, but what's the deal exactly?
There's no deal. I see him every week and a half, he calls me up, he shows up somewhere, and he burns my fucking house down.
He is married.
Yeah, I don't care.
You care.
You know what I mean.
And you know what I mean.
Let me control the way I tell the story, okay?
Okay.
There's an atmosphere in this guy. Murder. He wouldn't murder me, that's not what I'm saying. But it's there, like an aroma. I could smell it on him the first time we met. He was introducing himself, saying hello, being nice. Or in a public place, I remember thinking, gonna rape me. I'm seeing like police photographs in my head of me. And right like that, right out of that, I gave my phone number. I walked away like there was a camera recording me and music I was walking to. I felt like I was in a ghost story about love. A week later, we meet up. I'm alone with him for the first time. In his office. I walk in his office, he closes the door. And I feel this weight come over my arms and legs. I was scared. He was going to do something to me. I wanted him to do something to me. I was afraid, and I wanted to be afraid. I wanted the fear. I was so tired of being a good girl. I had this book, Return of the Native. And I just started talking about East Asa Vi because I was so nervous. But he didn't call me out. He didn't say, why are you talking about this book? It's not what's going on here. He just talked back to me about East Asa Vi. But while he talked, he put his hand on the bone of my chest and slowly started pushing me down. He never stopped talking about what I was talking about, but he was pushing, and I was going down. And then his hands and my whole anatomy, they went to another world, and we did things without words. It was like, what we were saying was like we were one bunch of people, but what we were doing was like we were in another room. There was a lot of blood. I got my period right in the middle. He's big. I mean, big. He had to go to the store and buy me a raincoat to throw over myself. Now I look like I've just been born. Do you know what I'm talking about?
Celeste!
What?
I don't like this whole freaking thing. What are you doing?
I know.
I don't see you for 2 years.
But you do know what I'm talking about, don't you? In some way?
No! Underworld.
Yes, I am. It's true.
But you are... I can't help you with that.
Well, straighten me out.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm inviting it. I want a reaction.
All right, I'll just lay it out for you. You're a whore.
What?
Don't, please. It's hard enough without you playing surprise. Don't tell me you haven't thought about the fact that you are a whore.
Natalie.
A stupid whore.
Natalie.
I'll break it down for you. First thing to count. Let's just count. You're 31. Next thing you're going to be, guess what? 23. No. 32. And it goes on from here. Older, older, older. A flight of stairs going down, down, down. You're like a quart of milk reaching its expiration date. Have you ever had someone on this date at Halloween? That's what you're facing. Are you ready? I don't think so. Is it just... Who cares? Pick the flag of God and see where you get. It's the truth of what it is to be a woman.
Not friends.
Friends! Then go to friends! Climb the Eiffel Tower, feed the pigeons. Maybe they'll be glad to see you. Please. You are in America. Do the math. Next, you've got to face the facts. You've got a birth defect. You've got a limb. How many parts are there for limping girls?
Laura.
In the glass menagerie. And that's it. Have there been any production to play?
Yes.
And did you get the part? It's time for you to stop office tending and play Romeo's girlfriend in acting class and get a bona fide fucking job. It's 2+2. You've got to draw the lollipop and pick up the carcass. Next issue, Kenny. This may sound tough, but I'm gonna say it anyway. Kenny is your best bet.
No way.
Yes, he's a loser, but what are you at this point? Maybe together you can pull the car out of the ditch and make some miles down the road. I know where you're at, Celeste. There's a million women like you. You don't want to look at your story because you don't like your story. So you just close your eyes and tell yourself a fucking fairy tale. And you know what that makes you? In a world of men? Totally exploitable. Because you want the lie.